Today, I'm going to show you how we can remove numbers from text in Excel. So I'll do a couple of versions of this. I'll start with an easy version. So I'm going to go ahead and add a row on top of this. Not really necessary, but I'm going to do it anyways. So for this easy method, I'm just going to go and just type this text with no numbers. So I'll just go next to it and type DFSD. Hopefully I got it right. So basically just the first one with no numbers in it. I'm gonna click right below in the next cell, and then I'll go under data in my data section, and I'm gonna find this thing called flash fill right here. It may look a little different on your screen, but it's gonna be here. Sometimes it's a big button in the middle, sometimes it's a smaller icon, but you'll see this arrow in there. That's what you're looking for, right next to this text to columns. I'm gonna go ahead and click on that just once, and that should take care of it. So as you can see, if I look at this one, it was able to remove all of those numbers, and for this one as well, all set. This should be fine if you don't need a formula. Now, I'm also gonna show you how to do this with a formula. So for that, let's get rid of this. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna first use a function called sequence. So for sequence, the way it works, you give it some number. Let's say if I give it 20 and close parentheses, hit enter, it will give me a sequence of numbers from, as you can see, from 1 through 20. So what I want to do, I want to make a sequence for as many characters as I have in this text. And the way I can do that, I can go back instead of this 20. I can just use this function len that calculates the length and basically just link to this cell. So this will calculate the length of that text. Based on that, we're going to create that sequence and see it starts from 1. Now it goes until apparently 27. So this text now has 27 characters. So why do I need this? Well, the reason I need this is that now I can use this sequence of numbers that goes from 1 through whatever it is within this function mid. And in this mid function, I'm going to provide this text right here, A2. And then we do a comma. And as a second argument in this function, let's remove this period that I did here. We need to provide starting position that we want to extract text from. So actually, let me just grab this sequence out of here. I'm gonna paste it back in a second, cut it. So if I do, for example, position 3, comma, and then do 1 and hit enter, see, it gives me D because the third character within this text, if we just grab one character, would be D. So this is what this 1 refers to, just get a single character, and we want to start getting from the third character. Now, instead of just giving one position, I'm going to remove that 3 and paste that whole sequence of numbers that gives me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all those positions. And if I do that and hit enter, what you'll see happens is that basically I just grab every character from this text, and we basically split it to different cells. We have an array of characters. So now because this is an array of characters, we should be able to work with this array of characters. And since I'm gonna need to refer to that more than once, I'm gonna use let function to store the results of that in a variable. So I'm gonna do let, and I'm gonna create a variable. I'm gonna call it text array, comma. That text array will become the results of this function, which will be this array of results. So that way I can just refer to that after this comma in my calculations. So what I'm gonna do with that text array, I wanna basically get rid of all these numbers. And for that, we can use different methods. For example, one of them, we can use filter function. So I can use filter, and in filter, we need to pass the array first. So we're gonna pass that text array that we have as a variable, which is basically this whole thing that we used to see, comma. And then we need to provide basically which ones to include and which ones not to include. So for example, if I do something like is number and then pass that same text array to this, which is that same variable. So I'm checking if that's a number or not. I'm gonna close parentheses. This parentheses is closing this. I'm gonna need another one to close the filter function. And finally, I need one more to close my let function. So let me just do this and let's hit enter so you can see what happens. So you can see I have no results and I have this calc error. Now let's go back and just change this instead of is number, because right now I'm checking if it's a number or not. Let's just wrap it in not and close this parentheses here again. Let's hit enter so you can see what happens. If you look here, what happened here is that I get the same thing I used to have before. So if I checked if it was a number, I got no results because it doesn't consider any of these a number, because even though they look like a number to us, 1 and 2, the results of that mid function are actually text. So it considers all of these as text. So as a result, if I just check if it's a number, we get no results, so we get that error. But if I do check if it's not a number, we get all of them. That's pretty much where we are. So I want to make sure that this should be looked at as a number. So what I can do here, I can just take this text array and I can just do some sort of basic calculation to force it to become a number. So for example, if I take this text array right now and multiply it by 1, so if we have a number multiplied by 1, we should get the same number. Like 4 multiplied by 1 should give us 4. 5 by 1 should give us 5. If I take r and multiply it by 1, I should get an error. So that's what I'm going to use in my advantage. So if I hit enter right now, you'll see that what happened, I basically just filtered out all the numbers from this result. Now if I go back and switch this instead of not to just get rid of that not out of here, I'll keep parentheses so it's easier for me to come back and add that back to this. If I hit enter, it's gonna give me the opposite. It's just gonna give me the numbers out of this, but not text. So I guess this same formula could be used to remove text and just keep numbers too. But we're just trying to keep text in this particular example. So I'm gonna go back and undo this last step. And now I have my not function here. So I was able to remove numbers from the array. The last part is to make sure that we put this all together in one piece of text. And that I should be able to do by just going around this and adding concat function. And I'm gonna do concat, go and close parentheses all the way down here, hit enter. And there we go. We got our text with no number in it with this formula. So at this point, I can just take this and drag it down. And it should just work for all of them. And that should do it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.